In the previous video, we wrote the script which returns news on a given topic, and these news are in JSON format. Now, in this video, we're going to go deeper and understand these JSON data so that we can clean them and then we can represent them to the user in a more user-friendly format. So if you didn't follow that video, that's okay. This script is pretty simple. All we do is we import requests. So requests allows us to perform HTTP requests. So we request the content of this URL using this method. So that's an HTTP request. You can do it with Python. You can do it from your web browser. So put the URL there and it gives you the content. All the time we visit web pages, we do HTTP requests, even though we don't realize that. So that will give you an R, sort of a request object. And if you apply the JSON method from that request object, you will get a dictionary. So a dictionary is made of keys and values. This particular dictionary that you get from the news API has an articles key. So that's the same dictionary. We can view this from Python, and you see this articles key here. So by doing that content, and then we access the key articles, that will give us the value of the articles key. The value of the articles key is this one in here. So it's a long list. Therefore, if we run this, we're going to get that list. Now, the first thing we want to do when we work with APIs is to understand for ourselves how these data are structured. And it's not easy to do that from this result here on the command line. This is just a string, it's badly formatted. So what I prefer to use to understand the data for myself is to use a debugger. So if you're using a modern IDE, you have a debugger there. On REPL, there's also a debugger, so I'm going to use that debugger. If you don't know how to use your debugger in your IDE, then it's fine. You can just view the video for the next minute and see how the data are structured. If I click on the debugger here, and then I can run this, but before I run it, I want to set a breakpoint. For example, you set a breakpoint at line 6 by clicking here and this dot shows. That means if I run the script using the run button of the debugger, what will happen is that the execution will freeze before the breakpoint. And that means here on this panel, I have access to the results of the variables in a nice format. So now the script is at this point, and therefore I can see the content variable. I can expand it. I can expand this window also. So you see that this is a dictionary format. So it has this articles key. And then you can also see the key in here. You can expand that, and the value of that key has other values. So it's a hierarchy of data. So for example, if I enter here a 0, I'll get the first article. And then this is made of other keys. So you have author, you have title. So if you add title there, you get the title of that article, or the content if you like. So that's a content, that's its value. So that's the first article, right? We have more, we have the article with index 1. So if you want to get the article with index 1, you do that. Or what you could do, I'm going to stop the debugger now. What you could do is you could store all the articles in a variable, and that will give you, so type articles is a list You see, it's a list of different dictionaries. So if you say for, now for article, in articles, print article title, for example, and that will give you only the titles for all the articles in the news feed. So it starts from somewhere, yeah, from here. There's one title for each line. So one title there, another there. And you can also get then the description along the title. So you can copy that and say description. Run. And so you get more data. Of course, you can format this as you want. You can do like title backslash n to create a break line, for example. Description backslash n. And yeah, that should improve. Here we go. This needs to be a comma. And we have a comma here as well. Let's run again. Yeah, so now it's formatted better. Here is the title. And then comes the description. You could also add a backslash n before the description to split it from the title. So that's the title, the description, title, and so on. So that's about the structure of the data itself. Now let's look at the structure of the URL again. Currently, this is a static URL. So I'd like to have a function instead, where the user can pass values for the keyword they want to search for. At this point, we only search for stock market news, so we want to make that more dynamic. And one way to do that is to write a function, define getNews. And what parameters do we want to give? Well, let's say the topic. Then we have from date to date. And then we have language. I'm going to leave this on English by default. And then we have more. Let me write that in the next line. It would be the API key. So you need to get the API key from the newsapi.org website. You need to go there and create an account to get the API key. For this, I'm also going to leave it as a default value, my API key, because this is not changing. The language and the API key are not really changing much, in my case at least. The colon, and let's remove those spaces. And so what I want to do now is to construct the URL. So that's the URL, I'm going to get it from there and place it here. So this is going to be an F string this time. It's F and yeah, like that. So instead of that, I'm going to place a placeholder. There goes the topic. And from this date, instead of that static date, I want to place from date, that variable. To date, sort by popularity, that's fine, I'm not going to move that. Language, instead of English, I'm going to put language, my parameter, and the API key is API key. That parameter. So once I have constructed the URL, then I want to apply r equal to requests.get and enter the URL there. Let me make some space in here. requests.get URL, and then we have the content is equal to r.json. Then we get the articles in here, and then we apply the for loop. But instead of printing out these results, what I'm going to do instead is I'll have an empty list here. Let's say results is equal to an empty list, and then I say here results.append, and then I append the title and the description and the article there. But this would be an F string, so F title, and then article goes inside the placeholder, but I'll change these single quotes here to double quotes, because we have single quotes inside in here. And do the same for the other variable, and then finally return results. Yeah, let's see what errors we have. Let's run. So those are the results from this code, but I'm going to comment this out because we don't need that anymore, and also call the function. So get news, topic is space, and from date is 2022 227, and to date is /2/2/28. The other parameters are default parameters, so that's all we need to do and run. And so these are the results list items. So that's the list. We wrote a function which gets the news. It gets the news titles and the news descriptions and stores them in a Python list. Of course, you can store these results in an Excel file, CSV. There are videos in the course on how to work with CSV files. So that could be an exercise for you to do to improve the script even further. But you can also make a web app and show these news on that web app. So that would be another exercise if you like to build web apps. And I thank you for following. I'll talk to you later.